Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Robert and I speak about tech topics including machine learning, cloud computing, and embedded systems. If you haven't done that already, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. In today's video, I will show you how to set up a Raspberry Pi Pico to read and display temperature and humidity values from a sensor connected to the Raspberry Pi Pico. Let's start by looking at the finished product. I use the Grove board from Seed Studio, so I don't have to solder any parts. I use the Raspberry Pi Pico, which sits on the Grove board. The board exposes some Grove ports into which I've connected the temperature and humidity sensor, as well as an LCD. You can see the temperature displayed on the first line of the LCD and the humidity shown on the second line. The setup is currently powered via USB from the computer, but it's possible to power the setup from a battery via pins. You will need to limit the power to 5 volts if you choose to do that and watch your power rating. The Raspberry Pi Pico is a new microcontroller board. The board supports multiple programming languages, including Arduino, C++, and MicroPython. When you purchase a new Raspberry Pi Pico, you can program it directly using either the Arduino IDE or any one of various IDEs such as CLion and VS Code. I've written a setup guide for these IDEs, and I'll link to that in the description below. This tutorial will utilize MicroPython, and you need to set it up on the Pico. To do that, you need to hold the boot select button while connecting a USB cable between the Pico and your computer. Afterward, you can release the button, and you'll see a flash drive appear on your computer. Next, open the flash drive that appears, and you'll see two files. Double-click the HTML file. Scroll down the page to the microcontrollers section and click on MicroPython. Scroll down to the section titled Drag and Drop MicroPython. Click on the highlighted section to download the UF2 file. When it's done downloading, drag the UF2 file to the flash drive. This will cause the microcontroller to flash and reboot. After it reboots, disconnect it from the USB cable. You'll need the following: a Raspberry Pi Pico, a Grove Shield for Raspberry Pi Pico, Grove 16x2 LCD version 2.0, and the Grove Temperature and Humidity Sensor version 1.2. I will drop the links where you can purchase these in the description. First, insert the Raspberry Pi Pico into the Grove Shield. Next, connect a cable to the I2C1 port and connect the other end of the cable to the LCD. After that, connect a cable into the D18 port and connect the other end to the temperature and humidity sensor. Finally, connect the USB cable from your computer. The setup should now power up. You're now ready to set up the IDE and write your code. Visit thorny.org and download the IDE for your platform. Install it and launch it. Go to the bottom of the Thorny editor and switch the Python interpreter to MicroPython. Copy the Python code from the GitHub repo linked in the description and paste it into the editor window. Name this file main.py. Doing this ensures that the code is run whenever the microcontroller boots up. Don't run the code yet. You need two packages. From the description, visit the link to the Grove packages and download the archive. Unzip it. Back in the Thorny editor, open the file named lcd1602.py from the unzipped archive. This file is located on the computer. Save this file to the Pico, making sure to name it the same. Repeat the same step for the dht11.py file. You're now ready to run your code. That's all there is to it. Feel free to inspect the code and make any modifications to the presentation. Until next time.